You can't just force somebody to pray out loud in school.
And that's what Lillian Skiles and Destiny Bailey say happened to their sister and two other students at Robler Middle School in El Reno Thursday morning.
One of her friends was trying to make her laugh, so she said, "My God." And I guess at that time, the vice principal had came around the corner.
Bailey says he then allegedly asked,
"What did you say?" And she said, "I'm sorry, I won't say it again because it offends people." And he said, "Bow your head and pray." And she asked why. And he said, "Just do it."
When News 4 contacted the superintendent's office, he sent us a statement that reads in part, "This was taken completely out of context. This was a playful exchange between our assistant principal and kids in the lunchroom before school. It was in no way a discipline action or anything of the kind. It was also not religious in nature or anything more than a humorous exchange."
She did not take this as a joke whatsoever, and neither did her friends.
His response, it being a joke, is a joke to me.
The two say the incident made their sister feel uncomfortable because she's not a Christian. And joke or not, constitutional law professor Joseph Tai tells News 4 it's unconstitutional.
The vice principal might have pulled off a hat trick and violated the three basic protections of the First Amendment, the freedom of speech, the free exercise of religion, and the separation of church and state.
We also spoke with the ACLU about the matter. They, too, pointed to the 1962 Supreme Court ruling that prayer in public schools violates the First Amendment.
A school cannot require, much less force a student to engage in religious activity. That is very well settled law. And when you have a teacher using the patina of government authority, encouraging that, whether in a joking manner or not, that is not proper.
A lot of people don't know about the separation of church and state, and that needs to be made aware.
Now, as you heard, Skiles and Bailey were not happy with the district's response, so they tell me they plan to contact the state superintendent's office. Kevin.